हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट द पोएम द डैफोडिल्स रिटन बाय विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ। विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ इज़ फेमस एज अ नेचर पोएम। ही हैज़ ऑलवेज रिटन पोएम्स बेस्ड ऑन नेचर। इन दिस पोएम ऑल्सो वी आर गिवन अ विविड डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द डैफोडिल फ्लावर्स विच आर ब्लूमिंग एंड डांसिंग इन सच अ वे दैट इट हैड कैप्टिवेटेड द अटेंशन ऑफ द पोएट। Though he was roaming about in a lonely way, just like a cloud. This memory was so much set in his mind that whenever he was sad or he was in a lonely mood, the scene of these daffodils always used to occupy his mind, and this always filled his heart with pleasure, and it seemed as if he was also dancing with the daffodils. This shows that nature has the power to heal the grief of humans if they enjoy the beauty of the nature, and so is described in this poem. So first of all, let's look at the poem, each stanza, and then we'll look at the theme and the figures of his speech. I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high over vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Now here we are told that once the poet was roaming about lonely, just all alone on his own way, and it seemed as if he was roaming about just as a cloud floats over the valleys and hills. Vales are valleys. So he was just roaming about when at once his attention was caught towards the group of golden daffodils which had grown beneath a tree and beside the lake. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. At that time, a cool breeze was also blowing, due to which these beautiful flowers, which were golden in color, they were tossing their heads in such a way as if they were dancing with the breeze. This scene was so beautiful that immediately it had captivated the attention of the poet, and he started gazing at them. Continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. Continuous as the stars that shine. Can we count the number of stars in the sky? No. They are innumerous. They are so much in number that you cannot count. Similarly, the poet wants to say that wherever he used to see, everywhere he was finding a group of golden daffodils which were grown all over the field, that it was impossible to count them. So he compared them with the stars which are always continuous in the sky. And these stars are a part of Milky Way, the galaxy in which we are living. They stretch in never-ending line. Wherever he used to see, he just moved his eyes all over. He was finding all over the field a large number of daffodils. So they were continuous and stretched in never-ending line. Wherever he used to see, everywhere there were flowers and flowers. Along the margin of a bay. That means along the borders of that lake, he had seen that all over that margin of the lake there were large number of flowers. 10,000 saw I at a glance. Now 10,000 here is exaggeration, in which the poet wants to say maybe he is just assuming that maybe 10,000 he could see 10,000 flowers at a time, at one time, at a glance. Tossing the heads in sprightly dance. Their heads were tossing in such a way in the cool breeze as if they were quite happy. The flowers were happy and dancing in a happy mood. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. You people must have noticed whenever a cool breeze flows, the waves of the water or the sea also start dancing. So it seemed as if both of them were dancing. That means the flowers and the waves. But the dance of the flowers was quite splendid even than the dance of the waves. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. Jocund company, a company that makes you happy. So whenever a poet who is there at that time will never be left unhappy. He will always find himself happy in such a happy moment of the nature. I gaze and gaze, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. Gazed and gazed, alliteration has been used. He's continuously staring at the flowers, and he is thinking that what type of wealth am I getting from this beauty of the nature. It was actually the wealth that anybody can feel from inside, and that is the wealth of happiness. For oft when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils. So the poet says, whenever I lie on my couch, when I am in a very sad mood, pensive means sad, or when I am lonely in the house, immediately that scene of the daffodils, which has been captivated in my mind, immediately that comes into my mind. And whenever that scene flashes upon his subconscious mind, it becomes a bliss of solitude. Solitude means loneliness. In that loneliness, that becomes a source of happiness for him. The scene of those golden daffodils, that becomes a source of happiness for him. And then his heart, which was quite sad at that time, or which was feeling very lonely, would be filled with pleasure. And it would seem as if the poet is also dancing with the dance of the daffodils. So this shows that nature has got the healing power. Whenever you sit with nature, if you feel sad, depressed, or you feel that you are lonely in the world, by seeing the beauty of the nature, immediately you are filled with gratitude, you are filled with pleasure that no, nature is also along with you. Nature is there to make you feel happy. And this shows that nature is always there to make human beings happy, and nature is always with them. Now let's look at the theme and as well as the figures of speech. The first theme is influence of nature on man. Nature has got a great influence in the life of man. Without nature, we cannot live. As we see around us, if we have got so many trees, we are able to breathe oxygen and we get pure air all around us. In this poem, the poet has used a large number of images like clouds, lakes, hills, flowers. All these are the beauty of the nature which has been described in the poem. So there is nothing superior to nature. Nature is a big doctor. Nature is a big healer which can cure all your sorrows, all your griefs from inside. As we can see a line, a poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. If you sit with nature for a while, for even an hour, if you sit, you feel that you are the most happiest person in the world, the happiest person. So the poet has compared himself in this poem as a cloud, and when he was passing by, he saw a group of golden daffodils which were planted all around beneath a tree and beside the lake. And the dance has been described as tossing the heads and sprightly dance. Sprightly dance means the flowers were feeling quite happy and the cool breeze was making them more happy, so they could dance very well. So this shows the inherent unity between man and nature. By seeing those golden daffodils, immediately he says that anybody who remains in such a jocund company, a company that makes you happy, will never be sad again. So the daffodils here have got the healing and the refreshing power of nature, as I've told you. So, because when he was lying on his couch, whenever he was lying there and he felt very sad or depressed or was feeling lonely, immediately the memory of those golden daffodils flashed upon his inward eye, in his subconscious mind. And immediately he felt happy. He seemed as if he was also dancing with the daffodils. So this is how nature influences man. Second is impulse of feelings. So here Wordsworth has defined poetry as a spontaneous overflow of feelings. or the emotions that occur in anybody's mind whenever they see the beauty of nature. So whenever he is lying on his couch, the memory of the golden daffodils is recollected, and then he feels happy immediately. He wants to say that the impressions of beauty of nature are so strong that even after many years of visiting those flowers or any type of valley or any type of beauteous hill stations that you people visit, that always recurs in your mind. And you feel happy whenever you remember those happy moments. Now let's see the figures of his speech. Here the rhyming pattern in the poem is that in each stanza the first line rhymes with the third one and the second with the fourth. That means the first and the third are in rhyme with each other and the second and the fourth line. Then imageries have been used, like Milky Way galaxy has also been used, in which we come to know that as we cannot count the number of stars present in our galaxy, similarly the daffodils were so innumerous in number that they could not be counted. Then the poet initially has given us the figures of lakes, clouds, valleys, hills. That means a beauteous scenery, the beautiful scenery of nature. Alliteration, as I told you, I wandered lonely as a cloud. So lonely and cloud mein LL are the consonants being repeated. Personification mein a host of golden daffodils, as if they are treated as human beings. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing the heads in sprightly dance. 10,000 is an exaggeration, but tossing their heads as if they are human beings who are tossing their heads in the in a bright way. Similarly, I wandered lonely as a cloud. The poet himself is comparing himself to the clouds, wandering clouds. Then onomatopoeia is there. Onomatopoeia may a figure of a speech in which sounds of words convey the sense. Fluttering and dancing may immediately we get that sense, how the flowers would have danced in such a way that fluttering sound occurs. Hyperbole or exaggeration, as I told you, 10,000 saw I at a glance. So these are the figures of a speech and the theme. So hope you have understood this poem, and if you have understood it, press the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.